everyone, my name is Karen. This is my channel, Rather Be Reading, and today I'm reading to you my July TBR. Now, I'm just going to be perfectly honest. I'm filming this a little later in the month than I normally would. It's the 11th today, and this won't be going up until like the 14th or something like that. And so some of the books on this TBR I've already read, but I structure my TBRs in a particular way. I'm sure you guys know if you watch my channel, I'm a very structured reader. And so like this is what my TBR was at the beginning of the month, despite the fact that I've already read some of the books. I'm just going to tell you as what the TBR was at the beginning of the month. So the first category on my TBR each month is my library books. And in relation to what I just said, the first two books from the library that were on my TBR I have in fact already read and returned to the library. So I don't have them because they were really overdue because I'm having a real problem with library due dates at the moment. So I need to get to all of these this month. So the first two that I already returned were Giant Days Volume 14, which is the final volume in the Giant Days graphic novel series, and Chew Volume 3. So they're the two that were on my TBR that I've already read. And then the rest I still have here still to read, which is an issue because there's still a lot of them and we're almost halfway through the month. So the next one I have is The Promised Neverland Volume 3. This is a manga collection about a group of children at an orphanage who discover that maybe everything isn't as it seems, and we're following that story. Really have enjoyed this so far. This is the third volume. I then have An Act of Villainy by Ashley Weaver. This is, I think it's the fifth book in the Amory Ames series, which is a kind of cozy mystery series, which I have been loving. I love this series. So really excited to get to this next installment. I then have Chew Volume 4, which is entitled Flambe. And yeah, I've really been enjoying this graphic novel series as well. This follows a man named Tony Chu. This is set in a world where chicken has been, it's like illegal in this world. And he works for a particular agency, but he is also a chibopath, which means that when he consumes something, he can see it's like history. And he uses that to help solve crimes by sometimes ingesting murder victims. So there's that. Next I have The Turn of the Screw by Henry James. This is the next classic that I've been planning to pick up. This is a tiny, short little book, so I should be able to fly through really easily. It's only 140 pages. I know nothing about this except it's about a governess, I think, looking after some children and something to do with haunting. Don't really know. And then the next one I have is The Bishop's Wife by Mattei Ivy Harrison. I don't know too much about this except I believe it's about a woman who is the wife of a Mormon bishop. And she starts to question the church and the way that it's structured, that it's very secretive and that there's a lot kind of going on. And then I think a woman from their congregation, I don't know if that's the right word in terms of Mormon faith, I apologize if I'm using an incorrect word there, a woman goes missing. And I think our main character gets kind of involved in that story. So there's that. And then the final one from the library I want to get to this month is Something from Tiffany's by Melissa Hill. This is clearly a women's contemporary fiction chick lit story. This one is about two men who are both shopping from Tiffany's one day. One is buying a gift of like a charm bracelet and the other one is buying an engagement ring, but their bags get accidentally switched and chaos ensues, I believe. And so I'm sure this is just going to be fun, lighthearted, like chick lit. So I've got that. The next category of books on my TBR each month is the books from my physical TBR. So the first two books here I have here are technically part of a series. So they are The Widow and The Child by Fiona Barton. These are kind of more, so this is like crime fiction type thrillers. They are linked by a common character, but they're not, like they very much can be read as standalones. This is actually a third in this series that I don't own, but I do plan to get out from the library, but this is the first two. I then have Burning by Danielle Rollins. This is YA. Danielle Rollins is a pen name for, is it Daniela Vega? Yeah, I think it's Daniela Vega who wrote The Merciless book. So this is YA. It's about a girl who is in a correctional facility. And then a young girl arrives who is being kept in like segregation, and we're kind of following that story. I don't want to say too much more than that. So got that one. I then have What They Knew by Avril Dean. This is, says, like, the big, like, tagline kind of on the back says, on a bitter January evening, three people are found murdered in the isolated Blackbird Hotel. The synopsis then goes on to talk about that there are three friends who decide to, like, try to renovate and open this, like, hotel together. So I'm not sure if they're the three who are found murdered or if they're, like, trying to renovate a hotel where people had previously been murdered. I'm not sure. This, I believe, if I recall correctly, was on a video that I did quite a while ago of the lowest rated books. I believe this has really low ratings, if I recall correctly. So we've got that. And we then have The River at Night by Erica Ferenc. This is a thriller, but I don't believe this is like mystery thriller. I believe this is like a survival thriller. It's about a woman who goes on a, she's really stressed, like a lot going on in her life, and a group of friends decide to go away for a weekend together. But it ends up being a, I think it's like a white water rafting trip. And I don't know what happens, but I believe it becomes like a survival trailer. It says on the back, no phone signal, no people, no help. So we've got that. I don't think it's like murdery. I think it's just survival. But I could be wrong. It might be murdery as well. I'm open to either. So we've got that. And then the final book on my physical TBR that I plan to get to is from the TBR teacup, my favorite time of the month. So time to pick one of these out. I finally actually read the book within the month that I needed to last month, which was amazing. So hopefully I can, now that I'm like back on track, I can actually get to this in like this month. So let's pull one out. Okay, I've got one. Excited. I have, you can't see it, it's written in my like dark green like more kind of tealish pen marker. This is The Passengers by John Mars. John Mars just became really popular, and I've only read one of his more recent publications, which I cannot remember the title of, but I really enjoyed it. And The Passengers is one that I bought recently secondhand. I think like late last year. So very, very, I think it's something to do with like a reality TV show where people are being driven around in self-driving cars. But they're on like some kind of reality show that they're not aware that they're on it, where like people are voting like which one of the passengers in these different cars is like going to die. I think that maybe it's something to do with the plot. I could be completely wrong, but I think that's what it has to do with. So that is the one for my TBR teacup this month. So excited about that. The next category on my TBR is eBooks, which, as always, so far this year, these are all NetGalley ARCs because I am forever behind on my NetGalley ARCs. So I have six eBooks that I'm, / NetGalley ARCs, and I'm really hoping to get to this month. The first of these is The Ripping Tree by Nikki Gemmell. This one is an Australian historical fiction set in the early 1800s. I think it's, early 1800s, early 19th century. About a woman who, I believe she's on a ship coming over to Australia when something happens to the ship. I believe she ends up kind of coming, floating ashore and being taken in by like a family who are colonizing Australia, I guess. And something, I don't really know too much about what the story has to do with, but I'm interested. It's Australian historical fiction, so I'm interested to pick it up. This is one that if you saw my January wrap up, not my January, my June wrap up that I mentioned, that for some reason, even though I've downloaded it, it's just not coming up on my Kindle. But luckily my library has an e-copy of this, so I will be still be reading it this month. The next one that I have is The Stepmother by, all of these NetGalley ARCs, if you're interested in any of these, they are all already out and published because I'm super behind. So if you're interested in any of them, then you can pick up a copy. So the next one I have is The Stepmother by Rose Khan. This one is about a woman who she's been like struggling to have a baby with her husband. He is a little bit older than her. She's, I think, in her late 30s. He's in his late 40s. And then one day he tells her that he's like a estranged daughter who's like in her early 20s, who he's had like no relationship with whatsoever, is going to be moving in with them. And so the daughter comes to stay and she ends up forming a really quite close bond with her. And then there's like a secret revealed and goes from there. The next one I have is What You Never Knew by Jessica Hamilton. This one is about a woman who grew up on a house that was like on an island when she was younger. But when she was about 12, her father went missing, just like disappeared. And she thought that since that happened, that the family had like sold I'm not sure if it's the house or the island. I don't know if they own the island or if they just own the house on the island, but she thought it was sold. She's now like in her 40s. Her sister has recently died. And when her sister dies, she discovers that they in fact still own this home. And so she travels back there There's a lot of obviously secrets from the past with her father's disappearance. She discovers when she gets there that all the people on the island believe that her father was murdered, not that he just like disappeared out of their lives. And so it's kind of all about that mystery. The next one I have is Bitterroot Lake by Alicia Beckman. This one is about a woman who was on a holiday to some kind of lake resort and had a kind of prophetic dream that something was going to happen, and she didn't do anything about it. Presumably she didn't realize it was like prophetic, but someone died, was like murdered or died in some way as a result of that. And she's been haunted by it ever since. It has like really impacted her life moving forward and like destroyed a lot of relationships that she's had. It's now years and years and years later, and she decides to travel back to this resort. And when she gets there, there is a murder that is somehow connected to what happened in the past, brings it all up again. It's about that story. The next one I have is The Jane Austen Investigates. I can't remember. There's a subtitle. I'll have the cover on the screen. It's the first in a new middle grade series that follows Jane Austen as I think she's 12. She is a young investigator, like trying to solve crimes. And it just sounds really, really fun. And so I've got that to read. And then the next one, the final one of my ebook category, is The Silent Suspect by Nell Patterson. This is the third book in the Page Northwood series. So I've read the first two. I've been really lucky to get all three of these from NetGalley. This one follows a main character named Paige. So these are kind of like standalone stories, but you're following the same like main character, who is a British sign language interpreter. She is herself hearing, but she comes from a deaf family. Both her parents and her sister are deaf / have hearing loss, and she is a hearing person, but she is a sign language, works as a sign language interpreter, and she gets involved in being a sign language interpreter for the police in crimes that are happening like within the deaf and hard of hearing community. And so this is the third book. This one follows a crime where a friend of hers, I think, contacts her because his house is like burning down. And when she gets there, he's managed to escape the house, but his wife has like died in the fire, and he ends up getting arrested for her murder. But he said to her when she first got there, like, he didn't do it, but then he refuses to say anything, or like communicate anything. And so that is following that story. Like I said, I've really enjoyed the first two of those. The representation is really spot on. Nell Patterson herself has worked as a sign language interpreter and comes from a background of having hearing loss as well. And then the final category I have on my TBR is the audiobooks. And so I have four audiobooks on my TBR this month. The first is Dragonhaven by Robin Hobb. This was on my TBR last month, but had to get bumped into July. So this is the second book in the Realm of the Elderlings series, which is the fourth series. No, sorry. It's the second book in the Rainwild Chronicles, which is the fourth series in her overall Realm of the Elderlings world / series. This is a four book series. It's the second of those. And following that, the next audiobook that I wanted to get to is In a Holidays by Christina Lauren. This is their most recent. Well, I don't know if it's the most recent, because I think there's one coming out about now, but this is one that came out around Christmas time last year. You might think it's strange that I'm reading a Christmas book at this time of the year. I've never been someone who cares about reading Christmas like themed books at Christmas. I think partly because all Christmas themed books for the most part are set in like a setting where people experience cold Christmases, and that's not my Christmas experience. I live in Australia. It's normally hot as balls here on Christmas, so it doesn't bother me to just, I just read whatever, whenever. It doesn't bother me at all. This one is about a, it's set at Christmas time, but it's about a woman who, she is traveling to a like cabin where her and her family and like a couple of other like really close family friends all travel there for Christmas every year, and it's like the best time of the year for her. She loves it. It's really special to her. But this year something kind of goes wrong. She's had a crush on one of like this close family friend. There's two brothers, and she's had a crush on one of them for like forever, but she ends up accidentally making out with the other brother. And then she feels like the whole holiday's ruined. They are leaving. It's after Christmas. They're on the way home when they're in a car accident, and she is all of a sudden jolted back in time to the, on the plane, like flying in for the holiday at the start of the holiday. And it's kind of like a Groundhog Day type situation. So we've got that. I then have Honeybee by Craig Silvey. So Craig Silvey wrote Jasper Jones, which is one of my favorite books. He's an Australian author, and Jasper Jones is described as being like the To Kill a Mockingbird, like Australia's like To Kill a Mockingbird. It is fantastic. And I've never read anything else by him, and this book came out last year and got a lot of buzz. We're following a boy named Sam, who sometimes gets referred to as Honeybee, who at the start of the novel, he is standing on a bridge planning to take his own life when he encounters another man, an older gentleman on the bridge who is also kind of there, perhaps to take his life. And basically they end up speaking to each other and forming kind of a friendship. And we're following that story. So we've got that one. And then the final audiobook that I'm hoping to get to this month is The Road by Cormac McCarthy. This is kind of a modern classic that I've heard a lot about, but at the same time don't actually know what it's about. I know that it's somehow dystopian. I don't know in what way. I don't actually know what it's about. And I've heard really mixed reviews of it. It's one of those books that I've heard about for a really long time. Some people like rave about it, love it. I've heard some really like shitty reviews of it. No idea what I'm going to think of it, but I am finally going to read it and form my own opinion, or I'm going to listen to it and form my own opinion. So yeah, that is it. Those are all of the books on my TBR this month. I would love to chat with you guys in the comments down below if you've got any thoughts on any of the books that I'm planning to read this month, or if you want to chat to me about what you guys are planning to read in the month of July, or have already been reading in the month of July, because this is going up a little late. I apologize. I would love to chat with you guys in the comments down below. Please like this video if you liked it. Please subscribe if you want to see more from my channel. That is all I have for this video today. Bye, guys.